Kiss My Badge, Match Week 18 for the fans, by the fans, previewing the best league in the world. So, we have just gone through the counselling session for London clubs, fans. I feel like I'm a counsellor. Yeah. So, we are going into, that is just now we talk about the first big match, which is actually Spurs hosting Chelsea. So, this week we have actually two big matches. Spurs versus Chelsea and Manchester City, which is number 3 versus...
Among you counsellor? But in 30 years, right, you don't have credentials.
That's why, no, that's what
me. Among us four, right, only one team has credentials.
Which is West Ham.
West Ham win league before, eh?
Yes.
Alamak, siap. Okay, two teams has so credentials.
That, so that means that actually, no, I have credentials because 30 years I never win league. So I have that experience to counsel to counsel clubs like this. So the second big match of the week will be Manchester City hosting Leicester at the Etihad. Wow, that is actually number 3 on the table versus number 2 on the table.
What do you think?
I think City needs to win. They need to win because they are 14 points behind Liverpool. But the thing is that when Liverpool keep winning, right? People always see the gap between Liverpool and City, but people never see the gap between City and Leicester. So, I think it's for City to win. City is at home, but I love the way Leicester play.
Is it better for Leicester to win City so that they are closer to Liverpool?
In terms of the title race, yes. Yeah, because if City loses again. Because there's this feeling that it's always City is the nearest contender to Liverpool. Whatever Leicester does, right, it's always City. Yeah, I think near so for the name, for the sake of the title race getting more to get it more closer, let's hope Leicester to win lah. But City at home, although they lost to United the last home game, but you always favour City to win at home.
What do you think the score will be?
Maybe in a 3-1.
For me, I'm biased because I like Oasis and I like Manchester City. like he said, I enjoy the way that Manchester plays. Because they're very good. It's very entertaining football. Manchester City right now is in a slump, I think. And then it doesn't help that Pep Guardiola is bitching and moaning in the papers. And I don't know what they're going to do to their morale. So, but they have good players, but I think right now they're in a slump. I think this is what you realize that they got a long fight ahead to catch up with Liverpool. Yeah, which is going to be an uphill battle for the second half of the league. And then, but to be honest, I really want it just to win. Because it's, I'm sorry, I like the underdogs also. And the Leicester is like almost like, you know, you it's a club that, I think you ask the people on the street, Leicester, who that? I don't know.
Leicester,
who that? I don't know. You only know Arsenal, Man U, and Chelsea. But Leicester, I want them to really, really catch up with Liverpool. So it'll be a nice fight. It'll be a better fight than just a two horse or one horse race.
Head to head is not that far off. Because if let's say consider City against Leicester, right? For the past 16 games, Manchester City has won 8 times, Leicester has won 6 times, and then there's 2 draws. So actually, not that far off.
Quite close.
So it can be over.
Even though that I predicted City to win, right? If Leicester were to win, the gap will be 7. Liverpool didn't play. Not going to play this weekend. The next week is Leicester against Liverpool. So if Leicester were to win that, it will be 4 points with Liverpool game in hand. So for the sake of the title race, even though I predict City to win.
To make it nice.
Aku tak ketawa. I'm not laughing at you.
I know lah. Wow. It's a long shot. Even like it's a long shot. So then it'll be a better race because the points are smaller. But I know because I think it's too far ahead. And then you know like if the situation is this school the same, right? And then that's it lah. They'll put all the way lah.
Well, they did slip even with a 11 point lead lah.
Last year we did. That's why I think you guys never discount. You guys never discount that we will sleep.
Post January, first February, we'll see how it goes lah. But for the Manchester City and Manchester City match, I'm I don't want to be biased, but I don't think a draw would be okay for me. Mm. But I want the Chelsea to win. But I don't think that's possible. Looking at the way both teams are playing, I think the Chelsea will dominate, and then Manchester will be like standard, like clueless, cheap, like close, you know, kind of thing.
Wow. Yeah. Scoreline? Any prediction?
2-2.
2-2.
Yeah.
I think 1-0 to Leicester if there is no magic from any individual in Manchester City.
Yeah.
Because
especially Kevin De Bruyne.
Especially Kevin De Bruyne. Especially Jesus. Sterling. Yeah, because
that day he has stomach ache and never play ada chance lah.
Betul tak? Yeah. Who knows, right? Because even the last game where Leicester versus Norwich, it was because of Pukki. Right? Yeah. It was like a normal ball, then he just did his magic.
Yeah. It was a very brilliant goal from
brilliant Timo goal.
It's a brilliant goal. I mean, people are not, it's against the grain of play lah. People are not expecting, goal. Wow, it's good. It's
yeah,
good
I goal. Want Leicester to win because they are playing as a unit.
Yes,
I like teamwork.
Yeah.
But I think with Manchester City, right, it just takes one moment of brilliance, then that's it. Then, you know, you can lose to that.
Yeah.
Right? But I think I want Leicester to win 1-0.
1-0.
Yeah. What about you?
I want draw. I want draw lah.
Obviously
of course. Of course.
But I think City will win.
Yeah.
2-1. I feel like City will win 2-1. I feel like Vardy will still score. Mm. But because Vardy will definitely take advantage of the mishaps of Manchester City's defense. Mm. With their defense now, I don't think so they can cope with Vardy.
Mm.
But I think Manchester City will still win. Their attack is just too good lah.
Midfield battle. What do you think?
City has always no problems with their midfield. Yeah. It's a defense which is problematic. Yeah.
They have a leaky defense.
Yeah.
No offense to Arsenal. Same problem.
But between Leicester's midfield and City's midfield.
No. I think be honest, Manchester City's midfield is way above and beyond Leicester. Yeah. But because the attack for Leicester is a bit more, I think compared to what Manchester City has now, the attackers not very effective right now. So Leicester's are. They're hitting the ground running. So that's why I think there's a chance for Leicester to win. Yeah.
There's a thing about what Brendan Rodgers has done with Leicester City. Individually, their players are not like on paper. If you compare like to like with City, they are not that good.
Night.
Yeah.
But different.
The way they play is pale in comparison. City is more to an individual piece which you can put here like FIFA lah, play FIFA game lah. You put here and then they can play good. But for Leicester City, it's like puzzles that Rodgers has actually said to them. Okay, let you play this way, you play this way, and then everything click, and then they play for each other. That's why you can see their gameplay is so nice. Their attacking is so fluid. The way they play is like wow, and Vardy has been scoring and all that with all the supplies.
He's a top scorer now, right?
Yep, 16 goals.
16 goals.
So you can see all his midfield is doing a good job lah. He's supplying him, and of course his individuality skills is actually there also lah, top notch lah. But they are playing as a unit, which is actually nice to watch lah. I'm scared of Leicester more than Manchester City actually. So if you're asking me, like, I'm afraid
as a Liverpool fan.
As a fan,
you're
I'm
more
afraid of Leicester because the way they play is so fluid. They can counter attack same like us. No, the way they counter, suddenly defend and then counter. Wow.
Yeah.
Same. So it's like very scary.